Hi everyone, in this video we are going to build a multi-agent chatbot using Typebot and n8n, a bot that is not only able to chat but also perform specific defined actions. If you haven't heard about Typebot before, it's an open source software that enables you to create interactive chatbots, and basically you can use the cloud version or host the software on your own server without any limitations. But now you may be wondering why to use Typebot at all when you have very good chatbot interface already in n8n. Well, n8n is great for building LLM chatbots. This means sometimes open-ended fuzzy responses, but you also may want to implement the very structured form to your chatbot. So for example, newsletter signups or order forms. In such a case, you may want to use Typebot to actually implement the very strict logic to your chatbots. And today we are going to connect those two worlds together. On the top of that, we are going to add the multi-agent logic. So basically user will be able to chat with multiple agents and all those agents will share the same memory. But enough of talking, let me just show you how it works. All right, so right now I'm in Typebot instance on my own server, and let me just tell you what this bot actually does. So basically this bot is responsible for answering questions about Typebot and n8n documentation. So I can ask the questions about specific functionalities of those two apps, and the bot should respond to me with the very clear answers directly from the GitHub documentation. So just let me show you how it works. So I can choose between Typebot and n8n agents, and at the moment maybe I will just ask Typebot agent, for example, the question how to use variables in Typebot. What it does under the hood is basically connecting with n8n, and agent in n8n is searching for the specific part in the documentation and responding with the clear answer. And yes, this is exactly what it does at the moment I receive the information on how to use variables in Typebot. But let's say a user is quite engaged in the conversation and wants to join a newsletter. So maybe can type something like, I want to join newsletter. So basically what it does, it's performing the action to ask the user to type in the email address. So I'm going to enter workflows@gmail.com, which is my email address. It will also ask about my name, which is Oscar. And yeah, I received the information that all is done and I can run the conversation further. But maybe at some point I want to change to an n8n agent. So I can say something like, I want to change agent. So it will say bye to me and simply ask about what kind of agent I want to ask further. And I can ask, for example, an n8n agent. And just to show you how the memory sharing works, I will ask the agent on what was my last question. And basically it should tell me that my last question, last message was about joining the newsletter, because this is the last thing that I asked the previous agent. So as you can see, things working here like really good. And let me just walk you through step by step on how it's done. Okay, so let's start with the Typebot chat flow, and let me just show you step by step how it actually works. So in the very beginning of the chatbot, right after the initiating of conversation, bot is setting session ID. Session ID is basically the random string, random ID that is stored under session ID variable, and it will be responsible for actually connecting the conversation with the specific blocks in the memory of the agent. So basically right after I click the test button and the conversation is initiated, in the background bot is setting this random session ID. After that I have the select category block where I have two options. The first one is Typebot and the second one n8n. So basically user is able to choose between those two agents. And after that, I have the set category block, which is basically the very simple script that is responsible for transforming the string from the block before. So when we have here, for example, one uppercase character and for example, emoji, this script is responsible for converting it from the string with this emoji and uppercase to fully lowercase and without any emojis. It's important for further steps in n8n workflow. After that, we have the initial message. So basically, chatbot is asking, how can I help you today? And user is able to enter the question. The question then is passed together with other data to the n8n workflow, which I will show you in a second. And also two variables are set here. The first one is message and the second one is action. And when it comes to the next block, it's actually the conditional block where action is directed to the specific path in the chat flow. So for example, when I have the exit agent action that is being stored in the variable action, so basically agent recognized that user wants to exit the agent, it will jump to select category block. So it will jump right here. So user can choose once again which agent wants to utilize. Or for example, when the action is being recognized as newsletter sign up, user is being redirected to the newsletter block where is asked to enter the email and the name. And after that, this data is being also passed to the other n8n workflow that I will show you, and eventually user is being redirected to the block initial message. So basically right here is being asked to enter another question to the agent. So basically this is the whole logic in the Typebot chat flow. And let me right now show you how it looks like in n8n. All right, so let's move quickly step by step through this n8n workflow that actually does the heavy lifting. So it starts with the chat trigger, which has the specific URL. And this address is also set here in agent call block. So basically here we have the HTTP request node and we have the very same address. So basically in that way, we pass the data from Typebot to n8n. And after that, we have the very important block, which is set actions and reactions. Here we have the two variables which define how agents should behave for the actions and what those actions actually are. So we have two actions defined. The first one is exit agent, when user wants to change the agent that is running the conversation with, or for example, submit the email address for the newsletter. And in the reactions variable, we have information how agents should react for those actions. And for example, for exit agent action, agent should politely say bye and send the friendly emoji. And very similarly, for the newsletter sign up, also should inform about data collection for the submitting the email address for the email list and also add the emoji. After that, we have the very simple chain to define the action. So basically, here we have the instruction. We pass the actions from the previous nodes. And this chain is responsible for recognizing what kind of action user wants to perform. If none of those actions that we have defined in the previous node is suitable in this case, it will simply pass the value other for the action. And we have also here the very simple JSON parser with the very simple structure. So basically we have the property action and other as an example, because we use the generate from JSON example functionality in n8n. After that, we have the we set the defined action. So basically we pass it further to the workflow to utilize. And we have the merge input and defined action. So basically we pass all the data from the input. We pass actions and reactions and also defined action that is being recognized by the chain. We pass it together to the merge node and it's being passed further to the agents. But we have also here the switch agents node, which basically as you can see, we have here the variable category. This is basically exactly the same thing as we have here in this run script. We defined the value of category variable and we passed it here to the n8n workflow. So right now we are able in the switch node to simply define what kind of agent user wants to chat with. So after that, we go to the very main thing, which is the docs agent. Basically, I did this split to those two agents for the purpose of this tutorial. In a real workflow, those could be like most probably just one agent, but I wanted to distinguish it to the two separate ones and simply show you how it works. So how actually those bots know what the documentation to ask and how actually do it. So basically it's not the most elegant way how I did this, but I simply added the path list of the whole documentation in the context window. So how I did that, basically when you go to, for example, docs.n8n.io and go to the sitemap, you can see that we have very structured form of the whole documentation. The same is for GitHub. And what I did here is I've prepared a very simple workflow where I pass the address of the sitemap. And eventually I receive in the output the simple text file where I have those paths in a very clear form. And in that way, I can simply let the agent decide what kind of URL should be visited to retrieve the information. And since the documentation form in docs domain and in GitHub is basically the same, I can utilize the GitHub node to simply retrieve the information from the GitHub after a very small and minor modifications. So after that, after the whole processing through the agents, we pass the data to the merge output, because basically by default, chat trigger is in response mode when last node finishes. So basically it's passing back the data from the last node of the workflow. So yeah, let me show you maybe how it actually works on the real example, on the real executions, and I will show you what actually is happening in the background. Okay, so at the moment I'm going to run the chat flow and show you the executions in n8n. So basically I'm going to click test in Typebot. I'm going to ask once again Typebot agent about variables. So I'm going to ask the question how to use variables. And basically when we go to the executions tab in n8n, you should see that we have the Typebot connection workflow working. And after a few seconds, I should receive the information that webhook has been successfully executed and receive the information here in Typebot, so the answer from the AI agent. This is exactly what happened here, and I have the answer. All right, and when I go to the executions tab, I should see that this workflow has been executed correctly. And let's go step by step and let me show you what happened here. First of all, in the trigger node, I received the information on category. So what agent user is talking to. The second one is message, so the question from the user, and session ID. So the ID that is being passed here to the memory. And yeah, we have here defined the session key. Basically, then we have a defined action chain. So here, since it's the question from the user that doesn't require an action, we have the other output here in this node. And eventually, I go to the docs agent for Typebot. And as you can see in the logs, Typebot has executed the file path to editor variables and for the file variables.mtx and retrieved simply the data from this file from the GitHub repository and constructed the very well structured response. All right, so this is how the simple answering for the questions works. But for example, when user asks, can I join newsletter? we can go to the executions tab once again. You should see that Typebot connection is working and is being executed correctly. And is asked about, user is asked to give the email address. So when I go to the execution tab, and you can see that at this moment here in the define action chain, instead of other, I have the action newsletter sign up. So agents already know that user wants to sign up for the newsletter. And actually I have here the base row table, which is at the moment empty. And when I enter here my email address, which is workflows@gmail.com, and yeah, my name, Oscar, I received the information that all is done, and I go to the base row, and as you can see, the this has been submitted here. So I have also the separate workflow for email submission. So basically I have the separate webhook, which is defined for the newsletter signup action right here. And I pass the data to this workflow to actually pass it further to base row. And I have stored it here very well. So this is basically how the actions and multi-agents work in Typebot n8n connection. And I think you can do a lot of great stuff with this. You can utilize it for customer support, for many other things that I think have really huge potential. If you find this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel and to my newsletter, link like always in the description. And yeah, see you soon. Bye.